Hello, my beautiful, beautiful bag-loving people. So today I am bringing to you a much anticipated comparison of the Chanel 19 and the Coach Pillow Madison. Okay, so now I've heard people talk about how the Pillow Madison reminded them of the Chanel 19, and I thought, well, let's do a comparison video. And just for reference, currently here in Australia, the Chanel 19 in the small size, which is what I have here in front of you, retails for $8,430. Meanwhile, the Coach Pillow Madison retails for $895, which is almost just 10% of what you would pay for a brand new Chanel 19. Yes, that's right, right? Imagine being able to create a lambskin bag. Yes, that's made of lambskin and calfskin, and this one is goatskin. So being able to create a lambskin bag, which is what Chanel is known for and sell it for $895, that's full price, versus $8,430, okay? I mean, it's a no-brainer, right? I was actually thinking of getting myself a second Chanel 19 in white, but I didn't want to shell out $8,500 to get that. I got this particular one from Vessier Collective SA secondhand, but I still paid almost $7,000 for shipping, authentication, and taxes. Okay. And this one I actually got from Farfetch, brand new from a boutique in France. And it was on sale on Farfetch for $709, and I had a 15%. They were having a sale on sale, 15% off, and so this came down to $612, including shipping. But I've been talking a while, so let's get into the actual comparison of these two bags. Right, so let's start off by measuring both of these, and I'll start off with the Chanel one. So let me just get my measuring tape. Side to side, just measuring it from the bottom, this is 26 cm, okay? And then I'm gonna measure from that to here, and that is about 15, right? And then in terms of depth, that's about 9, 10? Yeah, 10 cm. Okay. Moving on to Coach end to end. So let's get that from here. See, this is the problem with this bag. Because it's so puffy at the bottom, it doesn't sit, or it doesn't stand on its own. This is about 27 end to end. And then measuring from the bottom to the top, you've got about 17. And I kind of expected that because I already knew that this was taller. And then in terms of depth, it's about the same, 9-ish, 9-10, right? So there we go. Let's see if you're going to stand. It keeps falling over because the front part is quite heavy because of the second flap here, which covers the front pocket. Okay, there we go. So because of that, and because of the turn lock as well, oh, look at that. It's standing on its own. Wow, a miracle. Now, I've just discovered that in order for you to be able to get the Coach bag to sit, you need to balance the weight. So because this is front heavy, you need to have the chain sitting at the back so that it'll stand on its own. Unlike the Chanel, because it's flatter at the bottom, doesn't have that issue. Okay, so let's talk about the similarities of this too. Now, my Chanel is in goatskin. So, and this one is in a combination of lambskin and calfskin. Okay. So both of them have turn locks for closure. There we go. This one turns up so that it opens. This one turns to the side for it to open. It's got the CC, and it's got one has got the C emblem there. Now, whoop, see? Balancing act right there. Okay, let's try and get this right. Now, the Chanel one comes in a thicker, what do you call this? Chain. A thicker chain. It is similar in the sense that leather is interwoven into the chain of the Chanel and the Coach chain right here. Although I've heard quite a few people on YouTube say that they wish that the Coach chain was thicker, similar to how the Chanel 19 is thick, because this bag, when filled, tends to become heavy, and then the chains would dig into your shoulders. I haven't found that to be the case for myself, but I guess it depends on the person who's wearing it. Now, in terms of how the chain is structured with these two bags, so the Chanel one actually comes with a top handle chain, so you can actually use it as a top handle bag, and then the rest of it is long so that you can carry it shoulder length. I usually would carry it cross body, but I am short enough for me to be able to do that. If you are taller, it might not sit well enough or in the spot that you would prefer it to sit. Okay. Now, the other thing that they are similar in is that they have back pockets. Okay. If you will notice, the Coach one, I think, has done a really good job at aligning the stitching just as much as Chanel is famous for doing that. So Chanel's bags are always have their stitching aligned. I do know of some quality issues in some, especially the classic flaps, wherein the flap doesn't actually sit very well onto the bag, so it kind of looks crooked when it's closed. But yeah, so I digress. So yeah, they both have their stitchings aligned on the pocket, on the back, everything. When you move it to the front, the stitching is also aligned on the Coach and on the Chanel. Both back pockets have magnets for closure. If you have been watching me on this channel, you would know that I sometimes complain about how strong the magnet is on my Chanel 19. So much so that I've had to put a piece of plastic in between the magnets because I just am not able to open the magnet or the back pocket otherwise. Both I have emptied the bag so you can see that they slouch like that. Okay, now the Chanel 19 has got fabric lining in the pocket, and the Coach Madison has got a fabric or microfiber lining there that feels a lot like suede. Okay, you can see that there. Now, if you open this up, you've got fabric lining and then a zippered pocket at the back, like that. Okay, if you open the Coach one, so it also has a zipper pocket at the back, which I think is a very similar feature with both. But the difference with this is that the Coach one has got this extra flap, which, to be honest with you, I do not understand why there is an extra flap there. And I'll tell you why in a little bit. So when you open this flap, it also has a magnet very similar to the magnet at the back pocket, okay? And it's a very good one wherein it closes well, but it's not difficult to open, right? And then when you open that up, it also has that suede or microfiber material. Now, on the website, it says that this is a mix of lambskin and calfskin. So if it says that the outer part is all lambskin, so all of this puffy leather that you're seeing is all lambskin, including the leather on the C. However, inside, this is where the Napa leather comes in. So the interior lining, that is leather, and this one also, the back part is also calfskin. It is only this front area and the sides that are microfiber. Okay, the zip is very smooth, no issues there. The lining in the zipped pocket is fabric that has the Coach logo inside. Now I've also got here at the back all of the essentials, or what I would normally carry in my Chanel 19. So just to demonstrate, okay. So we've got, this is my Coach wristlet, which houses like a small medicine kind of, it's got all of my allergy tablets, some lip products, perfume, mini deodorant. I even have dental floss in there. Yep. So yeah, I carry that. Okay. I've got my two Louis Vuitton Kirigamis. This one houses my earphones. This one is used as my wallet. And I also have my Chanel key holder, which doesn't have my key at the moment, but you get the gist. So I'll bring those in. Okay. I've got my Laneige compact and my hand sanitizer. All right. Let's see. Can I fit you? Yep. And my Ray-Bans. Will it close? It closes perfectly. It fits everything. Yep. And if I wanted to, I can put my phone in the back, but I always carry my phone just in my pockets if I have pockets. So let's see if what fits in here will fit in the pillow Madison. Okay, so we've got all that out. Let's see. Here we go. We'll try it out. It's proving to be a little bit. Let's see. It will fit, but it's not as it's not as good as how it fits in my Chanel 19. Yeah, it's a little bit difficult to close that, but it can close. There we go. Here's the thing. Even though this is taller, a lot of its size is because of its puffiness. In terms of interior, and we can actually do that since I've got my measure tape here. Let's see. Okay. So you can even tell just by looking at it how much wider the mouth off the Chanel 19 is and how much more flexible that is. So if I wanted to measure the inside end to end, that's 26 right there. Okay. The pillow end to end is 24. So that's about 2 cm smaller, or almost an inch narrower. And then in terms of like how much, that's about 5 cm, whereas this is 7 cm. Again, another about 2 cm more open, or almost an inch. So that's why I can fit more comfortably in the Chanel 19 all of my stuff, whereas I have to struggle with the pillow Madison, because again, a lot of its size is because of its bulk, because of its puffiness, and not necessarily because it actually has that much space in it. Right, that was a revelation. I did not think that was going to be the case, but it is. It was a lot more difficult to fit everything in. And I think, again, this second flap here is getting in the way, because I think I would have been able to put in a little bit more if this wasn't there. So, or I wouldn't have struggled as much to close it anyways. So there you go. Now, I was saying earlier that I do not understand the purpose of the second flap when you could very easily just have another slip pocket on this side anyway without the flap. It is just a design that to me serves no function. Yeah, a design detail that serves no function, and in fact can be a hindrance, because it is because of that flap that people often find it difficult to close this, because that it gets in the way there. So it makes this farther away from the turn lock. So you have to like really push in, make it an effort to be able to close that turn lock, because this is actually getting in the way of that. So really, I don't think that this serves a purpose. In fact, it probably makes it even more difficult for people to actually close the bag. Like how I'm having difficulty now. There you go. The other design feature of this bag that I think could have been done better is this whole panel here, right? The sides, not so much, because that doesn't really impact the functionality of the bag, but the bottom, because what you see there is not a sag, but the puff, or the puffiness off the bottom. And because of that, on an even surface, it is pretty hard to actually get this to stand on its own. It will fall over. If they had done a similar thing here, where they've actually put some quilting on the sides and on the bottom, so that would flatten out this part a little bit, just like how it does here in the front or in the back, giving it a little bit more of stability. So that would allow this bag to easily stand on its own, right? So, do I think these two bags are comparable? Chanel fans would probably say, no, they're not comparable. What are you talking about? But in terms of quality, craftsmanship, this is actually a really, like this Coach bag is a really well-made bag. The only flaw that I've actually found on this is there is an extra thread that hasn't been cut. I don't know if you can see that. There's an extra thread there. But in terms of, in terms of everything else, the craftsmanship is beautiful. Like really the only flaw that would make me reconsider this bag is the fact that I can't make it sit properly. So yeah, I think if you are on a budget, you love the Chanel 19 look, then this Coach might be the answer to what you're looking for. If I didn't have the Chanel 19, I would probably be okay with just having the Coach one. Right, there you go. That's my take, that's my review, the differences between the two, and the similarities, what I like about each of them, and whether or not I think you should get one or the other. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, like this video, share it with anyone who would care about bags. And I'm going to link here as well the most recent video that I've uploaded, just in case you haven't seen it before. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next video.